Wife of the Prophet, peace be upon him. In this short video, I'll be speaking about Safiyya bint Huyayy, may Allah be pleased with her. After the Prophet, peace be upon him, reached the city of Medina, he made peace treaties with the various people who were living there at the time. Among them were the Jewish tribes that lived there in the city of Medina in pre-Islamic times, and the father of Safiyya, may Allah be pleased with her, was the head of the tribe of bani nadir, the Jewish tribe. They planned against the Prophet, peace be upon him, and tried to kill him, which is why they were later expelled from the city. Various verses in the Quran were revealed regarding this, and you can see some of those in the description box below. Like other wives of the Prophet, peace be upon him, Safiyya, may Allah be pleased with her, was also married previously, and she once had a dream where she saw that the sun was landing on her chest. When she told her husband about it, however, he was extremely angry and he struck her on the face, asking her, "Do you want to marry the king of the Arabs?" And in some narrations, a mark was also left on her face. After the tribes had been expelled from the city of Medina, there were many captives, among them was Safiyya, may Allah be pleased with her, and the Prophet, peace be upon him, gave her the option that she could marry him and would also receive her freedom, so later they were married. Some people misunderstand this and they think that Safiyya, may Allah be pleased with her, had no choice but to marry the Prophet, peace be upon him, and to convert to Islam, but in reality, she enjoyed a very high status among the Muslims. As an example, there are narrations that Safiyya, may Allah be pleased with her, was upset by comments made by the other wives of the Prophet, peace be upon him, regarding her Jewish ancestry. The Prophet, peace be upon him, supported her and advised that if anyone says something about her, she should say that her father is Haroon, her uncle is Musa, and her husband is Mohammed. What that means is it's a reference to her ancestry, so her father was a prophet, her uncle was a prophet, and she was married to a prophet. Also, from an Islamic point of view, whenever somebody is born, they're born free of sin, and also when somebody converts to Islam, all their previous sins are forgiven. Therefore, you will find that there are other companions of the Prophet, peace be upon him, who are of Jewish origin, such as Abdullah ibn Salaam, may Allah be pleased with him, who used to be a Jewish rabbi, but he converted to Islam. She died later and is buried in Jannat al-Baqiyah in the city of Medina, along with other wives of the Prophet, peace be upon him. Thank you for watching. I hope you found this video informative. Please like and share this video and subscribe to my channel.